From the art of photography, we turn to the art of myth-making, comic book style. During last year's Florida Supercon, Art Loft met with creative artists behind our favorite superheroes. And now, we can even reveal the secret identity. Take a look.
I started when I was a kid. I was 16 years old in the country I was born, in Argentina. My dream was always to do the comics here. For me, it was my fulfillment of my dream. Mis primeros trabajos aquí en los Estados Unidos fue hacer un cowboy, Billy the Kid. Y después de Billy the Kid, they gave me to do most of the TV series of those times. From there, I moved to Gold Key to do the Yellow Submarine. And from the Yellow Submarine to DC Comics. From DC Comics to Marvel Comics. The character that I enjoy doing is Batman. Batman is not just a superhero. Doesn't have those incredible superpowers. It's more a detective than a superhero. And as a regular human being can be hurt. Bullets can kill him. And he uses a lot of gadgets to do his work. I'm semi-retired, you know, and I'm still doing things, you know, because doing little pictures is my life.
I was a kid who loved to read comic books. Comic books were always interesting to me. I discovered very early on that I was very good at drawing, and I just continued on and on, and you know, to work my way toward where I always knew I would be by the time I was five. What we've done with this particular Superman is that we kind of strip down his ability and make him less super omnipotent and more of a Superman. Heroism should be hard. You know, it should be something that's a difficult concept even for someone who's superpowered. They should be challenged to the point where we can really appreciate them and what they're doing. Much like medicine or law, art is a practice. It's a skill that needs to be honed. And it's something that you will be doing for the rest of your life, one, because you love it so much, but two, because you never feel you really quite have it all. There are gonna be days you're not gonna like what you do, and loving it is what keeps you there.
Well, I have very vivid memories of superheroes when I was very, very young. In fact, I remember going into Woolworths in England with my granddad and buying my first Superman comic. Ever since then, when I was like 7 years old, I just loved superheroes and Superman. And I think it was also a bit of falling in love with American culture because, you know, American culture is intertwined with superheroes for me. Jack Kirby drew many of my favorite comics when I was a kid. It's been a huge influence to me. I think the favorite part of the creative experience for me is the bit where it's all still possible. It's when you've had the idea and you're just exploring it and you're doing really rough drawings or really roughly drafting a story out and everything is very possible at that point. And that's still where the magic is. The other end of it is a bit more craftsmanlike, but it's really that the little moment where the light bulb goes off. That's, to me, is a really, really exciting part.
When it came to Marvel, they had a policy of giving books they had canceled to newcomers and let them kind of try out on it because they figured they couldn't hurt it. One of them was Iron Man, and I told David to take Iron Man. And I had always hated what they had done with the Iron Man character. So I asked them, could we do whatever we want? And they said, yeah, we're going to cancel it. So we changed everything. That's where the rock star Tony Stark came in. That's where it came in looking like armor. And I did the variant armors. And we created Rhodey, the whole new cast of characters. And after three issues, it was selling like 300,000 copies a month. And the rest is history. I wanted to go to Hollywood and work because I had done everything in comics. I had owned two comic book companies. I've done everything but put staples in the books. And I wanted to see my characters talk and move. Something like that. And so it was the next challenge for me.
I started off at 3 years old. I loved to draw, and in high school, I won a couple awards for Youth Today magazine. I started drawing at 17 with commercial art, you know. And from there, The war broke out. I designed a plane. And I was drawing the field manual for the Army. And from there, I went to New York, and I worked for Steinberg Studio. And they says, would you like to draw Superman? And I made a sample. They liked it. And I worked with Superman for 30 years. And from there, I went to Batman, to the dailies. And every time some cartoonist got sick, I stepped in for them. If you could stay in a room and draw and not be lonely, stay with drawing.
This year, Florida Supercon takes place July 3rd through the 6th at the Miami Beach Convention Center. So log on to floridasupercon.com for details.